looking at the rocks, and here we have all the mudstone, and we have been looking at this pattern. This is where on the floor of the sea, and we think it's by some sort of animal that they've left behind. Okay, so this is a trace fossil. Yeah, we're not sure what it is, but we're investigating on what we think it is.
It's really heavy.
I'm pouring some water onto this brown rock to see what happens.
Yeah, where's all the water going, Corbin?
It's all been soaked in. Now I'm pouring water onto this different rock to see what happens.
Does it look like any
stuff? I can't say we've got one hand.
It sort of sits there as it runs off it.
I think it was like lower than this, and then it started to build up, and it built up over the forest.
It's funny because it's like black stuff, and then that, and then more black stuff, and then more of that. So that kind of interests me.
We're here at Airedale Beach, and there's fossilised wood absolutely everywhere. I've collected a piece here, and it's a piece of a tree trunk. We're going to try to work out what happened to this forest.
We're up on Mount Taranaki, and we're looking at different rock formations, valleys, and all the cliffs. It's created by erosion.
We're on Mount Taranaki, and we're in a gully where loose volcanic material has been washed down by avalanches and rain.
So we've been up the mountain in Taranaki, up at the ski field, and we've just come down on the track. And this here, right here, is a lava flow, and it's really hard and solid. And over here on the other side is a lava flow as well.
The rocks up there are very crumbly and easily fallen, which is why we have a tunnel here so people can just walk through without getting hit by the rocks.
Okay, here we have this kind of stuff, one of the softest things that makes up Taranaki. It's like, it's not that soft, but you can still scrape off edges like this. This layer is probably of some kind of like eruption, or maybe just a landslide or something that came down.
We've done a section of that cliff over there with a nice cross-laminated cut through, and then we've just come down with the boys to get this one here.
Oh well, in the layers, there's, as you can see, it goes from big to smaller in the layer, and then another layer starts, and then it goes big to small again. And there's about three layers that do it.
As you go up the cliff, it gets more gritty,
kind of.
At the top, there's bigger rocks, and then
they
get smaller.
Cool. Okay, so the bottom's sort of finer and grittier, then bigger rocks as you move up, and then get finer at the top.
Rocks are stepping out really far.
Yep.
So that sort of means that they're in quite soft rock, and that the weather's sort of
built the stuff around them to make them away. Some of the rocks are a bit like the rocks up in heaven.
India's on the way.
She's so
cold. Some way
to yeah.
No idea. Well, this one is the inside of a.
So in that same layer, it's contemporary with these. There's pumice or something, isn't it?
Oh yeah.
Wait, I'll try and find this.
These burrowing shells are cool, aren't
yeah.
they?
Yeah.
Vertical burrowing species.
That it's like thicker. Then up here, it's finer. Like it just crumbles in your fingers here.
Sample, figure out everything that's in there.
Look what I found on my feet.
Oh!
Yes! Oh,
yes, miss.
Wow!
Oh, it's like a spiral shell.
Oh, that is
no, 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 you look. Yeah.
We think this is a crab, well, like that, the pincher, and through all through there in the body there, you can see the texture in there, it's quite rough.